Good evening. You're looking live at Leonidoff Field at Tenney Stadium on the campus of Marist College in Poughkeepsie, New York. This is where the Kingston Stockade FC will play their home matches due to a stadium renovation back there in Kingston. Deet Stadium getting a massive overhaul, so we have to play the games in Poughkeepsie on the other side of the Hudson River. Tonight, we have an NPSL blockbuster with the 3-0 Kingston Stockade FC. Okay, we got the second half coming up here. I don't think that's a live image. We have the two linesmen and the referee with a solemn stride to midfield. That's what men who are in charge on a soccer pitch. Not too fast, not too slow. They know they got some time to kill. They go out under the Marist Red Foxes logo. In the center of the pitch, McDermott, this is his backyard. He's going to talk to the refs. We're good. Apparently, and I apologize, we had some technical issues in the first half. In fact, it might have been just a black feed in the first half. And that's okay. It's 2-0 Kingston. It was good practice for me. Now I can reuse all the references I dropped in the first half, and there were many, as usual. But, the Marist Press Box on a Saturday night, there's a lot of hospitality areas, and I see that people have taken advantage of the loungy-type chairs, and, you know, it's great. It's a Division I NCAA Press Box. It's too bad our tech didn't match the Division I standards. It did last week. They pulled it off, but apparently there was an unusual glitch in the service provider on 11 Sports, which I always associate with filmmaker David Fincher, who made one of my favorite movies, Seven. What's in the box? I always say when I pick up the paper in the morning and find out what the Pirates said, what's in the box score? No one laughs. We have the rain has stopped. It did rain in the first half, towards the end of the first half, and it stopped now. It's still low 60s here in Poughkeepsie, Tenney Stadium at Leonidoff Field. It's some background on that. 5,000 capacity here. It's named after the Pepsi-Cola of the Hudson Valley CEO, Tim Tenney, who pretty much backed the renovation of this place in 2007. I think he's on the board of Marist College as well. Skidmore, Owings, and Merrill were the architects of this structure, which has a certain Logan's Run quality to it. We've got these vertical rail doorknobs that are interesting. And Leonidoff is named after a local physician and big supporter of Marist Athletics back in the day. I think he might have even been an athletic trainer. This stadium is used by 5 Marist athletic programs. I believe the head coach of the Marist soccer team is here in the press box. I saw them win the MAC tournament against Ryder in November of 2021, and there was a pitch invasion. It was brilliant. They ended up losing to Providence in the first round of the NCAA Soccer Madness tournament in the bracket. And that's where we are, Poughkeepsie, New York. If you read Boys in the Boat, the historic 1936 Olympic rowing trials were held here. The lads from Washington State, I believe, went over and gave Hitler the business, along with Jesse Owens. You can see from this press box the walkway over the Hudson, which was the old railroad bridge, which they turned into a tourist attraction. That was the finish line for the rowing. And the rowing used to draw hundreds of thousands of spectators to this town back in early in the last century. Still a big rowing area here. That's all the high schools use the boathouse here in Poughkeepsie. And when the Hudson is right at 5 in the morning, they go out and they row. And I read that book. I didn't think I'd like it, but it was brilliant. I didn't see the movie, but it's all about hard work and craftsmanship and perseverance. You know, America. Here we go. Kickoff, second half. Kingston up 2-0. Hartford long ball to McGonigal is picked off by Dolan. I'll let you know if there's any subs as I see them. It's always an interesting... didn't seem to be any. They haven't really done a lot of second half changes. See, Molina's still in the game. He has kind of that skayfish haircut, that Chicago punk rock band back in the day. There's a girl who works at the Red Oak Diner who has the same hairdo. But the skayfish are pretty obscure. Guerra dancing towards the box, denied by Hartford. Oh, and they let the linesman know which way it goes. I'm sure he appreciates that. That was Jake Williams telling him what to do. Hartford throw easily picked off. Down goes Liam Salmon. Draws a foul in a pretty decent location for a free kick. A lot could happen from this angle. Grant looking over it, the Wayne Famous look-alike, the bald guy, their captain. Plays it to the right to Hugo. Not much success rolling that one in. There's a slip. Dolan controls it, heads it back to Dylan. Dylan back to Dolan. The times they are a-changing. Dolan plays it out as there seems to be a Hartford injury and some writhing going on the pitch. I like writhing. It's a great word. I don't want to be writhing. I'm almost glad it's not me writhing. But when other people are writhing, I don't seem to mind. And that's possibly not being tentative. It's 9 for Evan Southern. Forward is down. Is that on? Okay. Working out some tech stuff here with brilliant producer Kale Kepes. Versus the Shockers last weekend in Hartford, wherever the heck they're playing now. He's a James Madison product. And he's from South Glastonbury, Connecticut. I love how Connecticut towns, especially Hartford, they seem obsessed by directionals. Oh, I'm from East Hartford. I'm from West. You know, just say Hartford. Why does everything have to be East, West? And as you know, if you've ever driven in Connecticut, one cannot go East, West. It's all North, South. You're all on the way to Providence and Boston. Try getting to Bristol, the home of the mothership. Impossible. Takes forever. You know, you can go to Stanford and do some wrestling with WWE, who I was briefly employed by a couple years ago. Very brief employment, which is probably a good thing. And off he comes. Yeah, his forearm seems to have drawn blood. Okay. And Southern seems to be in some pain here. Or he's pressing hard to try to stop the bleeding. Meanwhile, Stockade plays it out of the back. Wow. Nick Hoop aggressively going after the the free kick. Mara goes down, falls to Hugo. Oh, a call against Mara by the ref. Interesting. He took the brunt of Jake Williams' shove. And Mr. Mara is whistled. Huh? Oh, actually, here we go. He's from Austin, New York, and he went to SUNY Cortland, the hometown of the great metal god, Ronnie James Dio. Holy diver indeed. He played the Chants here in Poughkeepsie. It was a legendary show. It was before I moved here. I've been told about it by many a local. The Chants is a beautiful old theater. It's not really big. It's a great place to see metal. All the metal acts stop in Poughkeepsie now. Saxon, Y&T, that kind of thing. Oh, the ref gets in the way and he has to whistle that. He's been pretty good about avoiding contact with the official select soccer ball. New ball thrown in. And another thrown in from the other side, so now we have two. Dipolito takes care of that business. Surprised his clearing the ball out of the field didn't go in the net the way he's playing. He's got two goals in this game. The own goal was actually looked at and awarded to Dipolito after some review. So he had a hat trick at Vallejo. He scored last weekend here against Syracuse. And now he's got two here today for the 2-0 lead. 51st minute at Tenney Stadium in Poughkeepsie, the temporary home of the Kingston Stockade FC. As I understand, we're up and rolling and you're enjoying this live stream. What would Tom Snyder say about live streaming? He used to describe regular broadcast as a color teeny, as the particles fly through the air. I miss Tom Snyder. Here comes Hartford. Shut down by the captain. Close range block with his upper shin. McGonigal's got to throw it in again. Williams trying to figure something out. McGonigal back with it deep in the corner. It's out for pretty much a bogus throw location. Taj Salawu, the defender from Holy Cross, like half his team, computer science major from London, England. We don't know what club he supports there. I think he grew up in Connecticut. Dispossessed by the orange. Forward by Guerra. Nice ball to Dipolito. Can he get to it? No. But if he did, damage probably would have been done. Likely that would have been deep trouble for Hartford City. And they haven't been in deep trouble in a couple years. They were 8 wins last year and 1 draw, I think. They got knocked out in the playoffs. It's forward for Hartford. Heads his own ball. Up, oh, whistle. Dillon came out for it. Cool breeze now, still to the southwest. Sun setting through the clouds. Floodlights are on here at Tenney Stadium. On the campus of Marist College. A D1 facility with a luxurious press box compared to the Deed Stadium WPA structure, which I love. It's got Cleveland Stadium written all over it. Probably built about the same year with the same bricks. Hartford trying to organize something. Wayne Famous plays it back. Taj plays it back. You're going the wrong way, as Americans like to say when soccer players play away from the goal. Southern back in, played off, his shirt falling off like it doesn't fit. He looks disheveled. Last helicopter out of Saigon. Here he goes. Julo plays it forward to Mara. Back to Julo, no, misses him. And who's there? Daniel Dipolito. Mr. Goal. It's a shot blocked in the box by Hartford. Played out. Guanza settles it. Now it's down the right to Liam Salmon, his debut. Ontario, Canada guy. Marist College Red Fox. Played into Mara. He sticks with it but loses it. Whistle. I think the flag was up on that one. It was close, though. Jameis Fight. Ginger keeper for Hartford City on the ball. Free kick. Reminds me of Fight, Rob Halford's band after he left Judas Priest in the early 90s. Not a bad act, but he spells it differently. He's F-I-T-E, and Halford's act is called F-I-G-H-T. Very metal. In the end, everything is very metal, or goth, in my world. Played out by the captain, falling down backwards. Hartford with the quick throw, deep in their own end. Some dangerously loose passing in front of Kingston players. Now it's a header contest. Mara to Dwanza. Over to Liam Sandin. He put it down. Some shoving. Dipolito gets to a back heel. Right to the captain Guerra. Nice play. His cross headed out. These are the kind of connections this team's been making. At least that I've seen, and I've only seen one game. I didn't make the road trips this year. You need good tires to be in this league. Yeah, they've been linking up. Guerra has been on fire with Dipolito up front, just persistent and energetic and just does not give up on any ball. It's fun to watch. I mean, it's Fight with the goal kick. Long ball, pretty decent. Headed back into midfield. It's going to be a Hartford City throw. Kingston with the calm bench. We've got a 2-0 lead here in the 56th minute over the big team from Hartford City. Ref hit it again. Southern is not impressed. He's gotten skinnier since the first half. He's taking weight loss tablets in his legs. I mean, the guy scored last weekend. I mean, God bless him, but slight of frame. And I guess they bandaged up his forearm, which is bleeding a bit ago. Dylan's got this one. He's just going to leg it up the left flank right in front of me here. Nice header competition there. Kingston comes out. Dipolito loses it. Whistle. Hartford free kick. I took off my glasses. Why did I do that? Was I making a point in a courtroom by taking off my glasses suddenly to address the jury? No. Hartford, another try. It's headed out back to midfield. Mara and Gilo too close together. They lose it to Parker Vasek. McDermott gathers it in. Vasek from Portland, Connecticut. Econ major at Northern Kentucky University. Have some nice bourbon products from that area. Dipolito with the ball on his foot. He scores again! He scores again! The Stocke bench goes crazy. It took him 2 seconds to settle it on his left foot and buries it over Fight's shoulder. Rips the cord. 3-0 Stockade. Dipolito with another goal. This is getting downright predictable. Hat trick, his second of the season. Sixth goal in 4 games. There's no stopping the lad. And he's wearing lucky number 13. I love that. That just came together nicely. And he's got a great shot. Fight had a pretty good chance to get on that, but he found the angle. Here it is, the fans jubilant with a commanding 3-0 lead over the conference power Hartford City Colts. Being boat raced here in Poughkeepsie. 59th minute, still some football to play here, but you gotta like this. Dutch guard running out of flags back there. Grant, his halftime talk apparently didn't work. Dipolito, another charge, a shove, a charge, a shove, and dispossessed. The Hartford guy using his hands, apparently he's allowed to do that. I didn't hear a whistle. Played forward. Hugo settles it. Mara battling in midfield. Wins that battle. Takes on Grant. Hugo, sliding effort, works. Back to Molina. Had a goal last weekend against Syracuse. Defender coming up and scoring on a deflection. Alberto Molina. Hopewell Junction native goes to URI. University of Rhode Island. Party school. Hartford forward with the header to nobody with the orange shirt. Try again. Another orange shirt. Duanza. Dolan. Hartford heading it back. Rather chatty crowd here in the press box at Marist. I like it. It's not the solitude of the Kingston Deets brick tower. We have an elevator here. Nice cross in by Julo, but nobody in attendance. Fight gathers it in. Ball distribution. But he runs out of room. Number 23. Mystery guy for Hartford City. That might be a sub. I don't know who that guy is. Volleyball here with the feet. Midfield, Hartford with the running throw. Evan Southern trying to get something together. Earns a throw. Or is that a corner? Apparently it's a corner. He barely got it on the in the corner circle thing. Just on the edge of the yellow markings that delineate the soccer pitch here in the football field. Fires it in, denied by Kingston. Hartford trying to put something together on top of the box. Mara gets it and is whistled as he's taken down with a heavy tackle. Played at the midfield. Some discussion now. Yellow card to McGonagall. Santa Monica native. Holy Cross player, Worcester, Mass, well represented here. As I said in the first half, which nobody heard, his dad was on the Drexel wrestling team, and his mom was on the softball team at Drexel. That's a sports family, people. Dylan with the goal kick. Or should I say free kick after the yellow card to McGonagall. He scored in every Hartford game so far. And I say so far. Work by the orange. And we have our first substitution. Zach Rabadi coming in for the game. It was a let's go Zach chant rising up from the Tenney Stadium Wonderwall, if you will. Zach scored last weekend against Syracuse. Great goal. He's coming on for Mara. More good work for him. He's had two solid home games in a row. He gets a big high five and a hug from Jamal Lee Simmons and the rest of the technical staff. Zach Rabadi in the game. Hopewell Junction native just down the road. There's a speed trap there, by the way, on the Taconic Parkway. Be careful with your speed. He's a, and also attends this college right here, Marist. His locker is probably still in the locker room. He could probably go back to his old dorm room with some White Claw seltzers. Who knows? This is a very familiar environment for these players. Maybe that puts them at ease. Throw in by Taj, the Londoner. Makes it all the way to the right side. Grant plays it forward, too strong. Dolan's going to run that down. No, Hartford keeps it in. Grant with a shot through the uprights. It's a field goal, another American joke about soccer. Not too many shots on goal for Hartford, but Grant had a chance there. Just got a bit under it there and went way over McDermott, way over the soccer goal and into the uprights of American football. The only thing I like about American football is field goals. I get kicked out of bars for that. Here's Hartford, midfield, looking for an opening. Just not happening. Julo runs onto the ball. Energy and speed. Grant manages to wrest it. But the whistle goes for a free kick for the Kingston Stockade. But Jacob Schulman seems to take a lot of these. Over to Guanza. He's got options. Back to Bunjaj. That's Bunjaj who has the skatefish haircut. I'm sorry, that reference was misidentified. Chicago art punk band from the 80s. It's hair and shoes that a lot of announcers use to identify players. No whistle there. And a skirmish in front of the Kingston bench. Goes out over the Hartford City bench, which only has about, what I can see, is two subs. It happens a lot in this league. Some of the rosters are tiny, especially on road games. A lot of graduations and stuff this weekend. Who knows? The commitment. Hartford is yet, as far as I know, to sub, unless someone came out at the half. They might have. Midfield, Guanza battles. Williams plays it forward. Evan Southern. No comfort there as Kingston clears it. Out for a Kingston throw. Went off of Wayne Famous. Also known as Mark Grant. Went to the Dominican College. Born in his hometown listed as Tokyo. Zidane is his favorite player. He's a business major. And he supports Man United. He lost in the FA Cup final today. Here comes Daniel DiPolito, which is a phrase that other teams don't want to hear. But the ball is recovered by Hartford. Down to Southern, too slick there. That was a skipping bounce. The Lurk Ball girl grabs the ball that Southern threw to the turf. I would like to say in disgust, but I don't think he's even registered disgust. 3-0 Kingston. That should disgust most Hartford City players and fans, because if this score holds, this, as Bjork used to say, wasn't supposed to happen. And this might establish Kingston as a good home, this stadium as a good home force, momentum, home cooking, as they say, and there are some pretty good restaurants nearby, but nothing like Kingston in the Stockade District, which has a whole different atmosphere. But we're glad to be at Marist. We're happy that they've accommodated this club, and we didn't have to, let's say, cancel the season because we didn't have a ground. Hello, NYCFC. It happens. Renovations in New York take a long time. So they surrender the ball, and he chips it into the net, Evan Southern does. Dylan McDermott not amused. Some of the crowd here at Tenney not amused. 69th minute. Stockade attacking the Donnelly Hall end. Donnelly Hall, a great 70s architecture, kind of student center for Marist College beyond the goal. And, of course, the requisite giant parking lot. Hartford throw. McGonigal seems to have some urgency. He seems to think they can get back in this. But no, it's not even his throw. So let's start with that detail. Again, he's hustling for the ball. Come on, son. Come on, let's go. I'm a poli-sci major at Holy Cross. College of Holy Cross. To the right side to Liam Salmon. There's a high ball in. Fight has to camp under it or kind of leap under it. There were people close to him, including a guy named Daniel DiPolito, who has a bit of a reputation at this point for humiliating goalkeepers. Grant plays it out. Probably looking for a good sushi place here in Poughkeepsie for his post-game meal. There's got to be one somewhere. And when I worked at the Poughkeepsie Journal, I had some of the worst Chinese food of my life. They would order it for the night shift as a copy editor. And I wanted to hit delete the minute I took a bite. Anywho, Grant on the ball again, chips it into an orange alcove of players. DiPolito chests it down, and now it's played forward for him. And he'll have no problem getting this together and making an scoring opportunity out of it. No, I was wrong. Nick Hoop says no. Denies DiPolito. Throw into DiPolito. Goes back to Galanza. Galanza over to Bunchaj. Back line is way up now. Maybe looking for a fourth here. Flag is up. Offside on that one. That was close. Joey Dolan trying to get out on the action. Fight with the goal kick, or free kick, I should say. I think his hair clashes with that kind of French's mustard yellow he's wearing. The gingers should always go with the green, in my book. I know Karl Lagerfeld or whoever, but it's, you know, you got to check the mirror before you hit the pitch. Especially if like you're playing in Italy or something. Taking a while for this kick. Fight finally hits a line drive up the right side. Headed by McGonigal. Settled by Doherty. Here's Taj with the ball. Two guys on him. He goes down. Oh, Paul goes against Kingston. Liam Salmon apparently gave him a shove, push, jersey pull combination thing. Ref. Like, can't do that. I'm going to blow this whistle. Tweet. Free kick in an interesting spot. Evan Southern is over it. Probably over it in all ways here. His arm's okay. There's DeVito, the coach, saying 1-1-1. He's calling a play there. He's wearing his parka. It's not that cold, dude. Southern lofts it in. Pretty strong. McDermott. Arms aloft. Grabs it. And will wait for his mates to get downfield. 3-0 Kingston in the 73rd minute. A hat trick by Daniel DiPolito. Second goal might have been a known goal by Hartford, but we're not going to split hairs, as I said earlier, which nobody heard. Sid, I think City made some subs, yes. Tim Ennin, the defender from Northeastern, is on the pitch. Mark Grant is sitting after another workmanlike effort. And in from West Hartford, his hobbies are drawing, fixing electronics, and gaming. That's a good combination. Sounds like a handyman. You know, when your Xbox goes down, he can take it apart and fix it. You can get back to being a geek. Taj, good battle there against Julo, wins it. Julo not happy with that. And offside by Hartford City. Just to add to their woes at this point. 75th minute. Maybe you can see the score on the screen, maybe not. I will take nothing for granted, but it is 3-0 to the good guys, as the Chicago White Sox announcer used to say. Can't remember his name. I'm getting a message that the Pirates beat the Cardinals. Life is good, people. Comes Hartford down the right side. Jake Williams trying to start something. Chipped in. Dylan came out. But no problem for Salmon to clear it. Here's Taj with the throw. I just don't see that many blue jerseys. Maybe it's the loudness of the Kingston orange. You just don't notice. But they did manage to play it out. Now they're on the right flank, and they're going to try that angle. Evan Southern over there. Blasted off of Joey Dolan. Evan Southern again with the ball. It's got kind of a Steve Albini quality to it. So expecting to break into some noise rock, dirgy music any minute. Steve Albini, a big black. Hartford tries to trickle it in. Denied there by Boomjaj. Another City player down and writhing in the far corner. That's a long trek for the medical staff, which doesn't seem to exist for Hartford City. Maybe the coach wasn't big enough. They could only take this many guys. I mean, this used to happen years ago in this league where, Boston City would show up with 12. You need some subs. I mean, they all have vast rosters, but who's available is the question. This is a corner for Hartford City, not Hartford Athletic, which is another team in Hartford that is in the USL or one of those other leagues above this one, where they actually have to pay the players. City does have a former Hartford Athletic guy on their roster. He's not playing. Maybe his check bounced. And this will be a goal kick for Dylan. Short one. Boomjaj. Out to Lee and Salmon. Julo picks it. Stockade now up on the left side of midfield. Very comfortable pace to this game. The captain dispossessed, but a throw to the orange jerseys. Again, 3-0 Kingston Stockade. In this battle for first place in the beginning of the Wooden Shoe Trophy competition for this year. And it does involve aggregate, so putting a three spot up is healthy for Kingston to get that trophy back. It's actually right behind the Kingston bench. Wooden shoe on a white pylon with a blue bandana on it. For the last 2 years, it had an orange bandana, so it's color-coded. Looks like Hartford is preparing for a keeper change, as I see 00. getting up. And Kingston has subbed. Pedro Cleish is on for the captain, Hugo Guerra. But another good game. Didn't see he got the armband. He's trying to figure out the... who the Kingston, or the Hartford keeper is coming on with wearing double zero. Haven't come on yet. Julo feeds it out. In the box. Cross, headed out, Hartford. The ref got out of the way there. Doherty plays it up. Plays it again off of yeah, double zero is Juan. Is Devin Juan. No information on that lad. Meanwhile, it is a city corner. Right to McDermott. Overhead ball distribution to Dipolito, falls and gets right back up because he wants the ball. Because he knows what to do with the ball. Evans, a lot of Evans on this squad. Taj has come off for number 17 for Hartford. Again, nowhere to be found on the roster. I have 17 as Ronan O'Brien, a midfielder from Manhattan College out of West Hartford, Connecticut. Another substitution for Kingston. Iari Harris, a Kingston native, going in for Poughkeepsie, is coming on for Daniel Dipolito, who pretty much gets a standing O from this crowd, as he should. Three goals, another hat trick, his second of the season. Hugs all around. Iari Harris, the forward. Hometown is Kingston, New York. He goes to SUNY New Paltz, his second year with the squad. He had a goal last year, if I remember correctly. He might have been on the road. Kingston clears it. He may have his first touch here. Interesting. Charging forward. Fight gathers it. No, it's not Fight. Sorry, it's Juan. Devin Juan. Hartford up on the right flank corner. Chip back. Still no entrance point to the Kingston scoring area box. Just denials. Deny, deny, deny. The drums have restarted. The Dutch guard was on a bit of a hiatus there from the percussion. Probably stunned into disbelief that we're beating Hartford City 3-0 here at Tenney Stadium in Poughkeepsie, New York, on the campus of Marist College. More subs. John Kowalski of Pound Ridge at a Holy Cross, so he knows all these guys. He's on for Julo. And Modu Baji, another Kingston guy out of Plattsburgh, is on for Liam Salmon. fresh legs. Looks like the skipper wants to maybe add to this lead, add on, as they say. 84th minute. Scoreboard reads Stockade 3, Hartford 0. No timeouts left. We're in the second quarter. This is a football facility, mostly. Marist plays like the Georgetown Hoyas and those type of teams. Decent football team, but never, they don't really. Bill O'Reilly was their punter, supposedly in the 60s or whatever. That's been disputed. It was a club sport back then, so you might have been on this. Cleaned since O'Reilly's appearance, the former Fox News guy. So we're totally, to Badgy, just played out of bounds. I didn't mean to say powerful throw up. That's not a good image. Hartford on the ball. Desperate for some scoring. Nick Hoop goes down. We got two Kingston natives on the pitch for Kingston. And I'd say 99% of the Hartford City roster is from Connecticut. Of course, Holy Cross or Central Connecticut State. Very few from far away. The dude from Santa Monica is a bit of an exception. I wonder what he thinks of Hartford compared to like the Santa Monica. I don't want to make that comparison. He might get depressed. Shulman off and Owen Siegel on. He had some action last week. Shulman had a decent game. Oh, the whole Stockade team has had a decent. When you're up 3-0, that's pretty decent. Or decent, as they say in Ohio. Here comes a Stockade. Offside flag went up very quickly on Modu Baji. He goes to Plattsburgh, SUNY Plattsburgh. It's practically Canada. It's probably still snowing up there. It's June 3rd. Hartford with a sloppy ball forward that trickles through. McDermott's going to let it go deep into the box, plays it with his right foot. Evan Southern's going to say, hey, pick it up. I'm from the other team. And we're about to lose for the first time in 17 games in the MPSL. Unbelievable. Historic matchup here at this point. McDermott with the long kick. Baji can't reach it for the header. Hartford heading it forward. Denied. Owen Siegel with his first touch. Guanza falls on a guy and crushes him. When number six falls on you, you're probably injured. Although it looks like a calf situation, possibly a hamstring. Still no trainer from Hartford City. It used to be that the Kingston trainer would come out and help the other team, you know, back in the day when the minimal. Yeah, I think the Kingston trainer is now helping here. Unless that's the Hartford dude. I don't know. He seemed to be coming from the Kingston bench. Get up, they're saying from from the crowd here. Haven't announced the attendance yet, unless I missed it. Hey, Jordan, have they announced the attendance? Okay, Jordan is in on the emails and texts that I'm not, and I just shout down this long press box, and he helps me out. Attendance tonight, 611 souls. We had 746 last weekend. Yeah, you thought it might be a bigger crowd for this, given the importance of this match. I have number 8 for Hartford as Noah Silverman, the injured guy, Central Connecticut State, now a grad student at Quinnipiac. He'll call you with poll information, and he's from Berlin, Connecticut. He's off now. What are they, down to 10? Oh, he's going to come back on. getting some refreshments. All right, midfield. Gwanza, Hartford recovers. We have a minute left here, people. Stoppage time. There might be a few more minutes because we have had some men down in the second half. Rolling up the West Berm there as a Hartford player was tackled. Dutch guard flags greeting him. They're ecstatic over there, the supporters group. Got to say, Hartford City, the Agents of Hail do provide an atmosphere, at least in Connecticut. I don't know how many make the road trip. I did see some before the game. They were gleeful that Boston City, who's now in another league, are the worst team on the East Coast. And they've given up a million goals and have a million red cards. We were not surprised. They used to be in this division. That game was always like a bloodletting. Kingston controlling. Closing moments of this fourth match of the year. About to go in the W column again for the men wearing orange. Against the team that has dominated over the last two seasons. They have not dominated anything here today. They might have got a good parking spot, and that's about it. Effort at midfield still. Tim Ennin loses it. John Kowalski played it forward, trying to link up with Modu Badji. Kowalski had a Pound Ridge, New York, the Holy Cross guy. He may have an IOU from some of these players from Hartford, the bar tab that he picked up in Worcester. If they have bars in Worcester that will let you in without a mass ID. Oh, corner here. They take it short. Down three goals. City has to be stunned to be in this position. Kingston crowd getting more lively as the closing seconds approach here. Gwanza in the middle has played the whole game, and he just towers over his opponents. I'll get his height one of these days. His hair adds to it, too, which is great. Backline clearance. Forward to Badji. Lost that header battle. Hartford forced to participate at this point. Back to the keeper. Frustration. The new keeper. Logging some garbage time minutes here. And why not? Saturday night in Poughkeepsie, live soccer in the low 60s weather. Nice chill to it. And beating Hartford 3-0. This was not the script that anyone ordered, although Kingston fans after last week were like, this team is looking good. And they are. Everything has gone their way, and they've earned it. The talent they have has been impressive. They got a deep roster, and they're playing without a lot of their superstars at this point. And the young guys are coming up and dominating. And DiPolito, this is coming out year. And let's not get too loose here. The referee has to be checking his Casio watch at this point. We have no way of knowing stoppage time in this league, which is one of the fun mysteries of announcing this particular game. Oh! Big cheer for a steal there on a run by Kingston, which probably should be the final effort of this game. A little step over there. Petro Klisch had some action last week against Syracuse. Did well. Gwanza with it. It's like, hey, it's called a whistle. It's on your right hand. You put it between your lips and you blow. Yet to happen here. Second half. Oh, goal kick for Hartford. This certainly is encouraging for them. They can string together four goals. No, the corner. Hartford pleading for the goal kick. This is a coffin nail corner. Netley is taking it short, going to linger there. The stone pillars of the entrance in the background. Nice evergreen. Lush campus here at Marist. Rolled in and collected by Devin Juan. I just don't get that name. I wish I had background on him, but I don't. It's fun finding background information on these players. It's like you're the private detective from Blood Simple. You wear a cowboy hat. Hartford going forward. McDermott is like, what are you guys doing? You again? Looking for a clean sheet here. He was denied one last weekend because Syracuse drew a penalty and scored in their 4-1 win for Kingston. So it'd be nice if Dylan can get a clean sheet here, which is a shutout for those people that don't follow the game. Well, Juan way out, collides with his own player. Bodgy with the effort. Hartford recovers, and there's the game. Final whistle. Victory in Poughkeepsie. Applause and a standing O from the crowd here at Tenney Stadium on the campus of Marist College. Full time, as they say in England. 3-0. Kingston over Hartford City. Dipolito with his second hat trick of the season. They're piling up. So there you have it. A great result for the Kingston squad in what is probably considered a two-team division. It's up to Hartford or Kingston to take the crown. The other teams don't seem to be stepping up yet. Vallejo, no. Syracuse, no. Shockers, they can be a spoiler. You never know. But they're off to not a great start. But there's still more games to be played. But Jamalis Simmons has to be glad to win the big one. As the fans are filing out here at Tenney Stadium, I'm Spike Brusho. It was my pleasure, truly my pleasure, to bring you this match. My second solo effort. This team has made it easy to call because they just flow. They connect and they flow. Syracuse looked terrible last weekend. Hartford, honestly, didn't look any better today. And hanging their heads as they leave the pitch here for the long drive back to the Nutmeg State. As the Kingston Stockade players go over to salute the Dutch guard who have their flares out. And the traditional song, Can I Kick It, is played post-game for Kingston and has been for many years. What a tremendous result for the boys. And like I say, the next match is a friendly on next Wednesday in Vermont at Burlington, and then the following Thursday into Syracuse to play Syracuse FC. So the schedule, yeah, they're going to do some traveling, but players probably going to do the traditional drumming on the Dutch guard drums after a win. I know Bakaj is big on that. Owner, chairman Dennis Dennis Crowley is over there, always with the team, always involved, hands on. Jamal lets the players celebrate, pumps his fist as he's coming back our way. Again, couldn't have been a better result for the lads. Glad to be here. Glad you were tuning in. Shout out to Bonnie Pfister in Pittsburgh with her Pirates Jim Beam bottle. It's doing the job. They won again. Shout out to Ruth Clark in Mount Vernon, Ohio. A great mom. And that's going to be it here from Poughkeepsie, New York. Temporary home of the Kingston, New York Stockade FC. And in the immortal words of Sammy Sosa, let's keep it continue. Thanks. I'm Spike Brusho. I'll see you next time.